Gymnasium here on the campus of Seton Hall University. Thank you all for coming today, and a special welcome to all those watching on the Pirate Sports Network. Last time we held a press conference here, it was August 2019, and we said that we were here to celebrate the return of one of our own. Less than 3 years later, we're all excited to say the same exact words. We are here to celebrate the return of one of our own.
No, I was a decent player. I played to give it 110%. Small, people counted me out, so I had something to prove every time. So I coached that way.
Holloway got it back, threw it up.
Holloway running the show.
Spin, gorgeous on the baseline.
I got guys from New Jersey and New York City. You think we scared of anything?
4 seconds. Holloway went to the floor, to the rim. Oh,
now, before we all get started, just a quick...
Holloway, Holloway, all the way!
No, I was
Kevin Marino. Then we will hear from our director of athletics, Brian Felt, who will introduce our new head men's basketball coach. Following Coach Holloway's remarks, we will have a photo opportunity in front of the backdrop with the dais group to my left here, and then with Coach Holloway's family. Following the photo opportunity, we will begin media sessions at the backdrops. Coach Holloway will begin with TV, one-on-ones at the same backdrop, and Brian Felt will be with print media at this backdrop. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming to the podium the 21st president of Seton Hall University, Dr. Joseph Nyer.
On behalf of 100,000 alums, on behalf of our faculty and our staff, and most importantly, on behalf of our students, we're pleased to say to Shaheen Holloway and his family, welcome home. Coach Holloway is truly a man that needs no introduction to Seton Hall. But we're grateful for his values, his focus on helping student athletes achieve in the classroom, in the community, and on the court. As this university continues to elevate and reach new heights in the academy, so too do we look to elevate and reach new heights in our athletics program, and specifically our men's basketball program. We're so looking forward to all that Coach Holloway brings to Seton Hall, brings back to his home, and that elevation that's about to occur. I'd also want to take a moment to congratulate our Director of Athletics, Mr. Brian Felt. Brian, congratulations. Building a division of remarkable coaches is essential to the strategy, and we're grateful for your relationship with Coach Holloway, and we know together that will achieve new heights on the court, in the classroom, and in the community. Coach Holloway, welcome home.
Thank you, President Nyer. And now please join me in welcoming to the podium the chair of Seton Hall's Board of Regents, Kevin Marino.
In the past 2 weeks, the entire basketball world has come to know what we at Seton Hall have known for more than 20 years. Shaheen Holloway is the real deal. I'm not just talking about someone who can recruit great players. He certainly is that. I'm not just talking about someone who can motivate great players. He's that too. I'm talking about someone who is legitimately a really wonderful blue chip coach. The X's and O's, the whole story, come from Shaheen Holloway. You watched it, we all watched it unfold on national television. I was thrilled to watch Shaheen Holloway take down a blue chip team in Kentucky, and I am even more thrilled to welcome him back to a Pirate blue chip team. God bless.
Thank you, Kevin. And here to give introductory remarks on our new head men's basketball coach, and I want to make special mention that in his 5 years as an athletics director, he's had to make two men's basketball coaching hires, and now each time it's been the same coach. Please join me in welcoming, it's really easy, that's it. Please join me in welcoming athletics director Brian Felt.
The first time worked out pretty good, Sha. I hope you can help me out on the second time. But thank you, everybody, and welcome to Historic Walsh Gymnasium. Before I begin the introduction of our new coach, I wanted to take a moment and just welcome and thank a few people that are here with us today. Certainly, I want to thank the folks up here with me on the dais, our amazing university leadership. First and foremost, President Nyer, for his vision and commitment to our athletic program and university. I also want to thank our Executive VP of Operations and Chief of Staff, Patrick Lyons, who certainly knows our athletic department well and has been a tremendous support. And of course, our Chairman of the Board, Kevin Marino. Kevin has a great passion for Seton Hall, and his dedication to our athletic department is unmatched. I also want to thank, there are many members of our Board of Regents and trustees here. I want to thank you for all of your support, and all of our former players that join us here as well today. It's great to have you with us. In attendance today also is our Essex County Executive, Joe DiVincenzo. I would like to welcome you to campus, Joe. Thank you for being here. I also want to welcome Governor Richard Cody, who's here with us today. Each of these gentlemen have been great partners to Seton Hall within the local community and throughout the state of New Jersey. Thank you, guys. So, yeah. It's an historic day. We get to welcome Shaheen Holloway as our next men's basketball coach. He's a former student athlete. We know the story, right? Former student athlete. Was a pretty good student athlete. Said he's an okay player. I think he was a pretty damn good player. Member of our Hall of Fame. He was an assistant coach here, and he's a cherished son of Seton Hall University. We don't always also just welcome back Shaheen. We welcome back his family. His wife, Kim, is here. Kim is a 2001 graduate. His daughter, Shantanique, who's not here with us today, 2018 graduate, and his two boys, Xavier and Tyson. Welcome home, guys. So as Pete mentioned, I kind of feel like I've done this before. A little deja vu, I guess. And as many of you know, obviously, I had the pleasure to introduce Shaheen several years ago in Jersey City as the coach of St. Peter's. Now, of course, I knew when I was hiring him that I knew he would help grow the program at St. Peter's. I knew he'd bring that tireless work ethic that he did as a player. And I knew his commitment to integrity and the development of student athletes was his best in the business. I'm not sure I could have predicted an Elite Eight run in the NCAA tournaments with upsets over blue chip programs like Kentucky and Purdue to happen in his fourth year. But I'll be honest, as I watched it, and as we all watched it, part of me really wasn't all that surprised. All of us watched, right? We saw Shaheen. We saw his team and the way his team embodied his beliefs. And specifically, we watched how he handled everything in the press conferences and all the TV appearances, a lot of TV appearances. My God, it was very Hollywood. But he remained the Shaheen Holloway we've all known. He speaks from his heart. He pours his heart and soul into his team. And his players respond, giving him that same work ethic and passion that he provides them each and every day. So the last time I got to do this, and we did this together, I ended my introduction in Jersey City with this quote. I said, as we made the decision for who should be our next coach, it was apparent to me that it was Shaheen Holloway's time. It was his time to lead a program, and he just needed the right opportunity. think we'd all agree that those words have proved true. And now I'm thrilled that the right opportunity comes here as his alma mater and his home. So it's now my honor and my privilege to ask you to join me in welcoming Shaheen Holloway as the next head men's basketball coach for Seton Hall University.
I'm not sure who played that music, but that's big time, right? Yeah. Queens get the money. Queens get the money. I like it. Queens. First of all, this is, man, dreams do come true. God is good. Like, man. Before I start, I want to thank Dr. Nair, Kevin Marino, Pat Lyons, Brian Felt, the Board of Regents, everyone giving this unbelievable opportunity to come back home. This is, I mean, I'm very choked up right now. I'm not sure what to even say. I don't have a voice, you know. First, you know, I wouldn't be up here if it wasn't for those 15 young men right there. So. Hold on. Pirate Nation, we could do better than that. Pirate Nation, those 15 young men right there, stand up. Get up. So, yesterday when I went to talk to the team yesterday and told them that I was leaving to come here, I went in the locker room around 3 o'clock. We probably stayed in the locker room from 3 to like 6, and it made it so easy on me because those 15 young men understood why I was making the decision. And it was so easy because those guys changed my life, and I'm very grateful. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. So now on to my future. These gentlemen sitting in the front row right here, fellas. I hope you guys are ready to work. I hope you guys are ready to work. Because that's what I'm about. I'm about work. I'm about hard work. No shortcuts, no nothing. I hope you guys are ready to work. And I know I watch this team throughout. I know what this team could do. So after this meeting, after this press conference, the first thing is going to be meet with you guys to understand what it's going to take to be played for me and understand the tradition of Seton Hall University. I want to thank Kevin Willard. 15 years ago, Kevin Willard took a chance on me. I didn't know Kev. You know, he took a chance on me, brought me with him to Iona. And then 3 years later, we came home to Seton Hall. And I'll never forget it. I'll never forget, is Dean Hobbs here? Where Dean Hobbs at? So, don't kill Dean Hobbs because he was Rutgers. He was a Seton Hall guy. He's still a Seton Hall guy. I'll never forget calling Dean Hobbs and telling Dean Hobbs that Kevin Willard was ready to be the next head coach here. And he said, "You sure?" I'm like, "I'm sure. Just give him a chance." And he brought us in. And I have to tell you guys, the first 4 years was tough, like really tough. But brick by brick by brick, we built it from the ground up. And we did it the right way. We did it with guys that wanted to be here. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do it with guys that want to be here. Guys that understand what a guy like Terry DeHaere did, Jerry Walker did. And since I'm on Terry, you know, everybody's talking all this stuff, like, I'm still waiting for my jersey to be up there. I'm not sure why my jersey's not up there yet. I graduated over 20 years. It should be up there already. 20 years? Yeah. But, you know, no, seriously, this is not about me. This is about these young gentlemen right here. You know, my goal is to make sure they understand to be champions. You got to be champions in the classroom, on the court, and in the community. And that's what I'm all about. So, guys, understand that. Last thing, I'm not going to be up here long. It's been a long 2 weeks, very long 2 weeks. There's too many people for me to signal out, but I'm up here because a lot of people put a lot of time and sacrifice in me. My family's sitting here, my wife Kim, who's an alum as well, my two sons, my daughter. My brother who's sitting here, who is my right hand, like him and I go through everything. And there's a lot of people in the stands. I mean, a lot of people. My last press conference, I probably named 75 people. I can't do that today. Just know that everyone's here to support me. I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. Thank you guys so much. You know, this week has been a roller coaster, emotional roller coaster. I lost my grandmother Sunday on game day. You know, she was the closest thing to God that I could know. You know, so, you know, it's funny because she said she wanted to be buried in Seton Hall Blue. How about that? She wanted to be buried in Seton Hall Blue. So this week we're going to bury her in Seton Hall Blue. And just so everybody know, I'm happy to be here. I'm excited. I'm back home. But I'm ready to go to work. So I'm not going to be up here long speaking. Thank everybody for coming out. I appreciate it. Just know I'm not going to mess this up. I can't mess it up. It's way too important to me. So I'm putting the work in. Thank you so much. I appreciate that, brother. Last time at St. Peter's, I said, "Let's go, Peacocks." I'm not going to do that. Pirate Nation, we here. Let's go. Let's get it.